Welcome back everyone. Though the topic is a bit complex to decipher, I thought of making it simple with this beautiful outdoor beachside location. The topic in question is modified Sennig's operation for correction of transposition of the great arteries. Transposition of the great arteries, also called as DTJ, is a cyanotic congenital heart defect in which there is no connectivity between the great arteries, aorta and pulmonary artery, and their anatomically normal ventricles. Many TJ patients have reached adulthood thanks to the atrial switch operations. In our case series, at the time of surgery, the patients were 3 months and 15 years old, and the duration of follow-up was 3 years, during which there was a good prognosis and hence no further invasive treatments were required. There was normal functioning of the right ventricle in both the patients with the exception of minor Baffer leak in the 3 months old, leading to no re-operations. Baffer-related complications is attributed to one of the reasons for re-operation following the Sennig's procedure. At the annual 3-year follow-up, the tricuspid regurgitation, the systemic atrioventricular wall status was moderate in 3-year-old and mild in 18-year-old girl. Both of the patients were in sinus rhythm and in New York Heart Association classification 1/2. Nonetheless, given the large number of long-term outcomes of Sennig's procedure survivors, the complications up to and after adulthood have gained more research interest. This article, which is published by Courier Journal of Medical Science, also determines of having the morphologic right ventricle act as a systemic ventricle. As per study by Dawes and colleagues, which we have quoted in our article, 2D echocardiography is an inferior diagnostic method compared to magnetic resonance imaging MRI and 3D echocardiography in diagnosing RV function, as they provide more intricate information. The hallmark of good right Sennig's operation is controlled RV dysfunction or no dysfunction, no Baffer leaks, and maintenance of sinus rhythm or long-term outlook. Further research activities needed to assess long-term outcomes and right ventricular function in this subset of patients.